Garlic, it does so many great things. There are dangers. I'm talking about them today. I did a complete video on all the benefits. People are on it for their blood sugars and stabilizing them, especially people who are diabetics. Blood pressure to help lower it, help prevent cardiovascular disease, heart problems, stroke, thrombus, clot formation. It's an antioxidant, antifungal, antibacterial. The list goes on. People love the effects, but there are side effects and dangers we're going to talk about today. I'll offer some solutions. At the end of the video, I'll talk about the dose not to exceed. So what is the correct dose? If you like these types of videos to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant, we're going to do more of them. Hit the like button below. Let me know you like these types of videos because garlic does make people look younger and there are so many benefits of and for the skin that I talk about in my complete video. I'll link at the end. Now, what are some of the dangers? Number one is blood thinning. Now, it's a positive thing if it prevents heart attack and stroke. Heart attack is when you get a clot in the heart. The blood gets too thick, if you want to think of it that way. We call it a thrombus. That's the most common type of heart attack where you get a blockage of a vessel. That's a heart attack. In the brain, we call that a stroke. When the blood is thinner, that's usually a good thing for many people because obesity, diabetes, people with other problems have a diet. People not taking water, they're dehydrated. That all leads to thickening of the blood or problems with blood flow, strokes, and heart attacks. So thinning the blood or having those antithrombotic effects that garlic has is often a benefit. But be mindful, there are situations where you don't want to have too thin a blood. Some people are on blood thinners because they've had those problems before. They've had DVT, clots in the legs. People are on aspirin, or people might be going to get surgery. In my world, if they're coming to get aesthetic surgery, if they're getting fillers, needles put in their face, it will lead to bruising or unwanted effects. So be mindful of that one. Number two, not too dangerous, but it's the number one reason why people don't take garlic. It's bad breath. I do want to hear from you on this one. What are your solutions? So please comment. I'll do a video on how to prevent that. A couple quick ones, of course, brushing, flossing, taking mint, crushed mint. Mint in water has been shown to help. Using a specific mouthwash after eating it. And of course, green tea, which has a lot of polyphenols and antioxidants, has been shown to decrease the breath problem associated with garlic. But it's difficult for a lot of people to eat a garlic meal and then have access to those products or to immediately brush your teeth. It's kind of cumbersome. So it is a side effect, and it's so common that people stop taking garlic, and that's unfortunate. We're gonna do a complete video on it, but I do wanna hear what you do about that. And there are supplements. There is aged garlic or garlic extract, black garlic, that we're going to talk about that I've mentioned before. So some of those can help, but sweating and smelling like garlic from the sweating would be a third one. That's a little harder to curb that side effect, but it does occur. Now, dizziness. I mentioned the blood pressure effects. Some people will get dizziness, especially if they get up quickly. But people that are on blood pressure medications, and especially uncontrolled, you can lower the blood pressure too much. And I know most people are struggling with bringing it down. That's a problem we have in many developed countries, but you can bring it down too much, or if you're already on those medications, people have to be very careful. You don't want to have falls or low blood pressure. That can be a problem. Digestive issues. I'd say this is the second most common reason people don't take these. Garlic is high in fructans, and as a result, as well as sulfur, people do get diarrhea, bloating, and gas, particularly if you eat it as a first food, so on an empty stomach. One quick fix for this is to eat it with your food and after maybe an appetizer or something in your stomach. On an empty stomach, bad news for many. Next up is GERD. You might know it as reflux. We call it gastroesophageal reflux. disease. Because it's so common, people are obese, garlic lowers the tone of that sphincter that helps keep the food in the stomach. But when it lowers the tone, and if people are obese or have other problems or are prone to it, the food comes back up in the esophagus and people get heartburn. A terrible problem, and then they're taking drugs to get rid of that. Not good. So it can cause heartburn, especially in higher doses and on an empty stomach. Now, what is the dose that you should consider taking? Well, not to exceed 3 cloves in a day, but 1 to 2 cloves are the accepted amount. I know in cooking it's hard because you're putting more cloves in because you're making meals for multiple people, but you can do the math when you're making a larger meal and allot the amount to 1 to 2 cloves per person on average. I do want to hear your solutions, and have you had side effects? Particularly, I want to do a video on bad breath because I think it's the number one reason with garlic people stop using it, and it's so potent, it helps people with so many problems. It's a shame not to be taking it. I put a complete playlist up here on herbs, supplements, things you can do at home, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.